Hello everyone and welcome. Today we're going to do a critical reception on an Abis padlock. We are going to talk about the Abis Rock, the Abis Rock 83-80 to be exactly. And this is one of the biggest padlocks that Abis offers. This is a CEN Grade 5 or SBSC Class 4 padlock. So this is one of the highest ratings that you can get for padlocks. The only rating that would be higher is the CEN Grade 6. So this is so let's take a look what we got here. The Abis Rock. It says here nano protect on the shackle, and on the back we have this 83-80 series 2 written, and the series 2 refers to a feature on the Z-bar which has to do with key retaining or non-key retaining, and but we're going to go in detail with that later because it doesn't matter on this one. This one is a padlock which is for oval cylinders. In this case we have a Pfaffenheim oval cylinder here, the Abis Deltas with inactive side pins, but we're going to go on detail on the core and on all the parts of the padlock later. Today I would like to talk about a problem that I have with the padlock, because at first it seems like a very nice padlock. It's very well made. The tolerances are very tight, so everything seems to be okay. It's very well oiled. It comes factory oiled, so you have some oil on the inside. Everything is really smooth, but then I recognized something. I removed the shackle and I recognized, oh wait, I got some rust on here. And I said to myself, hey, that's not possible. It's a brand new lock. So I ordered this padlock at my locksmith place. Here we have the package, and if you want to, I could also provide you with the name of my locksmith, or I could provide Abis with the name of my locksmith and the ordering number, because this padlock has just been ordered a few weeks ago and it comes brand new from Abis. So let's take a look. And this is what I've done. I've taken a tissue and I've removed that here, and as you can see here again we have some rust on there. So I was a little bit disappointed. I mean, this is a brand new Abis padlock. Why is there rust on the padlock? Because they say, okay, our new series 3 is covered with that nano protect, which is a chrome finish to me, if you ask me. How can there possibly be rust? And I'm not talking just about a little rust, I'm talking about a lot of rust in there. So what I've done is I tried to take a look at it with taking my flashlight and putting some light in there, but you'll probably not be able to see that now, maybe on the back. What we can see here, or what we should be able to see here, is that the chrome plating is only on the outside of the padlock and not on the inside. And even on those holes here for the shackle, you will hopefully be able to see that the plating does not go all the way through the body. So it will, maybe you can see that line here. So the plating will go up to this point here, and after that it will stop, and it will be the blank hardened material and the hardened steel. And this is not a good thing, because if it's not chrome plated inside of there, it can easily rust. I mean, this is a big padlock. It does not really matter if it will rust a little on the inside, but on the other hand, this is a brand new padlock, and I expect it to come without rust when I order it brand new. So let's do the following. Let's take one of those Q-tips here and reach inside of there and scrape it a little bit around. What we will get on it is rust. rust on a brand new Abus padlock. And if you ask me, this is really not nice. I mean, I do not want to have rust on a brand new Abus padlock. So if you ask me, they have to work here on their finish. They have to work on the chrome plating so it goes all the way through. I'm not quite sure, but I think those here, the 83 series, is made in China. So maybe someone from Abus has to go to the factory and tell them, hey guys, you have to work on your quality control. Because, for example, if we take a look at an Abloy padlock, you probably all know the 362 model from Abloy. And if we take a look at the Abloy padlock, we can see that it's all shiny in there. So the whole lock body is chrome plated fully. So also the inside, also the inside where here this Protec core is in, everything is chrome plated. Also on the Ankylos padlocks. Okay, this Abus Rock padlock, it's still a great padlock, and I will do another video now explaining what cores you can put in there and what I would recommend on, or what I've chosen. And but I would like to tell Abus that they have to work on their quality control here, and they also have to work on that plating for that padlock, because it has to go all the way through. I mean, I am paying nearly €100 for a padlock without a core, and I'm getting a padlock which is not plated through and wears rust on the inside. This is not cool. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this video and this critical reception. Next on, we're going to see a video with some explanation and how to reassemble reassemble and disassemble this padlock. And have a nice day and take care. Bye bye.